Good morning, students. Today we discuss about the argon pipes and formation of stationary waves in open argon pipe. An argon pipe is a cylindrical pipe having air column in it is called argon pipe. If both the ends of the pipes are open, that is called open argon pipe. If one end of the pipe is closed and the other end is open, then it is called closed argon pipe. Now, whenever a longitudinal wave is sent through the argon pipe, that wave get reflected from the ends of the pipe. Here, the wave get reflected when the medium ends suddenly and whenever the density or rigidity of the medium changes. Here, due to change in density and rigidity of the medium, the wave gets reflected. Here, this incident wave and reflected wave travel in opposite direction along the same line, undergoes superposition and forms a stationary wave. Here the wave is reflected from the free end. We know that whenever a wave is get reflected from the free end, a phase difference of 360 degrees occurs, like 2 pi radians occurs between incident wave and reflected wave. Now, when two waves are superimposed with a phase difference of 360 degrees or 2 pi radians, they undergo constructive superposition so that the resultant amplitude becomes maximum. And in a stationary wave, the resultant amplitude is maximum at the antinodes. So, at free end, always an antinode is formed. Alagakunda, suppose if a wave is propagating through the argon pipe and if it is get reflected from the closed end, like the rigid end. We know that whenever a wave get reflected from the closed end or rigid end, a phase difference of 180, like the pi radians, occurs between incident and reflected waves. Here, this incident and reflected waves traveled in opposite direction and superimpose with each other, form a resultant stationary wave pattern. Here, incident wave and reflected wave having a phase difference of 180 degrees. Whenever the two waves undergo superposition with a phase difference of 180 degrees or pi radians, the resultant amplitude becomes minimum. And in a stationary wave, the resultant amplitude is minimum, like the amplitude is minimum at nodes. So, at closed end, always a node is formed. And in a argon pipe, at open end, an antinode is formed, and at closed end, node is formed. Now, we are going to explain the formation of stationary waves in a open argon pipe lo stationary waves ee vidhanga erpadutayi telusukundam. For that purpose, let us consider an open argon pipe of length L. Now, whenever a wave is sent through the argon pipe, this wave get reflected from the ends of the pipe. This incident and reflected waves undergoes superposition and forms stationary wave. Now, depending upon the frequency of vibration of air column inside the argon pipe, the stationary waves are formed in different modes. Those are called harmonics. If the stationary wave is formed with minimum number of nodes and antinodes, then it is called first harmonic or fundamental harmonic. And the harmonics other than fundamental harmonics are called overtones. Now, the first harmonic contains minimum number of nodes and antinodes. We know that at free end, antinodes are formed, and in between two antinodes, there must be one node. So, the station in the first harmonic, the stationary wave is formed like this. The stationary wave is formed like this. Now, what is the frequency of that first harmonic? We have from this L equal to, L is the length of the argon pipe, the length of the vibrating air column. This is the distance between these two. We know that the distance between two successive antinodes is lambda by 2. Therefore, lambda by 2. From that, the distance between antinode to node is lambda by 4 plus distance between node and antinode is again lambda by 4. So, it becomes lambda by 4 plus lambda by 4, 2 lambda by 4, that is lambda by 2. From this, lambda equal to 2L. Lambda equal to 2L. Therefore, the first harmonic frequency or fundamental harmonic frequency is given by nu 1 equal to V by lambda. We have V equal to nu lambda. V equal to nu lambda. From that, nu equal to V by lambda. V by lambda. Therefore, nu 1 equal to V by lambda means here 2L. This is the first harmonic frequency where V is the speed of wave through the argon pipe. Speed of wave through the argon pipe. Whereas the next harmonic means this is the first harmonic. The next harmonic contains one more node and antinode than that of the first harmonic. We know that in the first harmonic there are two antinodes and one node. So, in the next harmonic it contains three antinodes and two nodes. Then a first overtone enter. In the same length there are three antinodes. There are 1, 2, 3. Three antinodes and two nodes. This is the first overtone. The harmonics other than fundamental harmonics are called overtones. First harmonic, first overtone, or second harmonic, first overtone, third overtone, second overtone, third overtone, and so on like that. From this, L equal to, now the distance between two successive nodes, antinode and antinode is lambda by 2, plus the distance between antinode and antinode is lambda by 2. So, it will become 2 lambda by 2. That implies from that lambda equal to 2L by 2. Lambda equal to 2L by 2. And the second harmonic frequency or first overtone frequency is given by nu 2 equal to V by lambda. Nu 2 equal to V by lambda. Here 2L by 2. 2L by 2. From this nu 2 equal to 2 into V by 2L. Nu 2 equal to 2 into V by 2L. This is the second harmonic frequency or first overtone frequency. Again, nu 2 equal to 2 into V by 2L means nu 1. First harmonic frequency that equal to 2 nu 1. 2 nu 1. This is the second harmonic or first overtone. Whereas the next harmonic or third harmonic, the second overtone, contains one more node and antinode than that of the second harmonic. That means the third harmonic contains four antinodes and three nodes. See, 1, 2, 3, 4 antinodes, three nodes, 1, 2, 3, and in the same length of vibrating air column it forms like this. This is the third harmonic or second overtone. From this, L equal to antinode lambda by 2 plus antinode to antinode lambda by 2 plus antinode to antinode lambda by 2. This will become 3 lambda by 2. That implies lambda equal to 2L by 3. Lambda equal to 2L by 3. Therefore, the third harmonic frequency, the second overtone frequency is given by nu 3 equal to V by lambda. V by lambda means 2L by 3. Nu 3 equal to 3 into V by 2L. This is the third harmonic frequency or nu 3 equal to 3 into v by 2l, new one, v by 2l, new one. This is the third harmonic or second overturn frequency. Similarly, the higher harmonic frequencies are obtained. And I mean fourth harmonic or third overturn, fifth harmonic or fourth overturn, like that. Here, the harmonic frequencies are in the ratio nu 1 is to nu 2 is to nu 3 is to and so on, equal to nu 1 is to nu 2 means 2 nu 1, nu 3 means 3 nu 1 and so on. Nu 1 gets cancelled, we get 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to and so on. That means in a open argon pipe, all the harmonics are formed and their harmonic frequencies are in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to and so on. This is the formation of stationary waves in open argon pipe. Next, formation of stationary waves in closed argon pipe. Closed argon pipe. The closed argon pipe means a cylindrical pipe which is open at one end and closed at the other end is called closed argon pipe. Now, whenever a wave is sent through the argon pipe, these waves get reflected from the ends of the pipe. These incident and reflected waves travel in the opposite direction and they undergo superposition and forms a resultant wave pattern called stationary wave. Now, as at the free end, as the particles are free to vibrate, always an antinode is formed. At the closed end, a node is formed. Here also, depending upon the frequency of vibration of air column inside the argon pipe, the different harmonics are formed. The first harmonic contains minimum number of nodes and antinodes, and the harmonics other than first harmonics or fundamental harmonics are called overtone in a term. Now, the first harmonic, this is L, is the length of the vibrating length. The first harmonic contains minimum number of nodes and antinodes. Here, at free end, antinode is formed. At closed end, node is formed. So, the first harmonic contains one antinode and one node, because the first harmonic should have minimum number of nodes and antinodes. So, the stationary wave is formed like this. The stationary wave is formed like this. Here, this is open end. The stationary wave is formed like this. Here, L is equal to the distance between antinode and node. What is the distance between antinode and node? Lambda by 4. Lambda by 4. From that, lambda equal to 4L. Lambda equal to 4L. And we know that we have V equal to nu lambda. From that, nu equal to V by lambda. And the first harmonic, like the fundamental harmonic frequency, is given by nu 1 equal to V by lambda. From that, nu 1 equal to V by lambda means 4L. Lambda is 4L. Where V is the speed of wave through the argon pipe. And L is the vibrating length of the air column in the argon pipe. This is the first harmonic frequency, like the fundamental harmonic frequency, V by 4L. The next harmonic contains one more node and antinodes. One more node and antinodes than that of fundamental harmonic. In the fundamental harmonic, there is one antinode and node. So, in the next harmonic or first overturn, contains two nodes and two antinodes. Therefore, next harmonic, the first overturn. The first overturn is formed like this. The first overtone, we cannot say it is second harmonic. The first overtone contains two nodes and two antinodes. Then here L will become equal to the distance between antinode and node is lambda by 4 plus node and antinode is lambda by 4 plus antinode and node is lambda by 4. So it will become 3 lambda by 4. From this, lambda equal to 4L by 3. Lambda equal to 4L by 3. From this, the first overtone frequency is given by v by lambda. V by lambda is 4L by 3. From this, nu equal to 3 into V by 4L. Nu equal to 3 into V by 4L. Nu equal to 3 into V by 4L is the fundamental harmonic frequency, nu 1. That means, after first harmonic form, the next harmonic is the third harmonic. Because the next harmonic, like the first overtone is, first overtone frequency is equal to 3 times greater than the frequency of first harmonic frequency. So, after first harmonic in the closed loop pipe, the third harmonic is formed. The third harmonic or first overtone, nu 3 equal to 3 nu 1. And there is the second harmonic is not formed in the closed pipe. This is the first overtone or third harmonic. Whereas the next harmonic contains one more node and antinode than that of the first overtone. In the first overtone, there are two antinodes and two nodes. Automatically, in the second overtone, it contains three antinodes and three nodes. Three antinodes and three nodes are formed in the second overtone. And in the same length of pipe, this is one. There are three antinodes and three nodes. This is the second overtone. From this, L equal to, now the distance, antinode to node lambda by 4 plus node to antinode lambda by 4 plus antinode to node lambda by 4 plus node to antinode lambda by 4 plus antinode to node lambda by 4. Totally, there are 5 lambda by 4. From that, lambda equal to 4L by 5. From this, the second overtone frequency is given by nu equal to V by lambda. That equal to V by lambda means 4L by 5. From that, nu equal to 5 into V by 4L. The first harmonic frequency. That means, here, after first overtone, the next harmonic formed is the fifth harmonic. That means, endukante, here, the frequency of second overtone is 5 times greater than the frequency of the fundamental harmonic. So, the next harmonic formed is the fifth harmonic. That means, in the closed loop pipe, after first harmonic, third harmonic is formed. After third harmonic, fifth harmonic is formed. Similarly, after third harmonic, fifth harmonic is formed. Later, seventh harmonic, ninth harmonic. Ila, only odd number of harmonics are formed in a closed pipe. And their harmonic frequencies are in the ratio nu 1 is to, nu 3 is to, nu 5 is to, and so on equal to nu 1 is to. Nu 3 means 3 nu 1. Nu 5 means 5 nu 1 is to and so on. 1 is to, 3 is to, 5 is to, 7 is to and so on. That means in a closed loop pipe, only odd harmonics are formed and their harmonic frequencies are in the ratio 1 is to, 3 is to, 5 is to, 7 is to and so on.